So if you have gone to a big bazaar, there is a in different malls also. Nowadays, many shopping malls will have a gaming point. There you may ride onto a bike, and a screen is there in front of the bike. And the way you tilt the bike, you have an accelerator, and you feel like you are actually riding a bike, but you are not. Okay, that is a simulation. That is simulation. That is a virtual way of riding a motorcycle. That is not real. When you are riding the bike, your Activa, your scooty, or your motorbike on the road, you self-start it, you put on to the gear, and then you accelerate. That is the real way of riding the bike. But when you are on some gaming point riding a simulated bike, so what you have the controls in your hand, and you have a screen which has a visualization that makes you feel that you are actually riding a bike, but you are not. That is a virtual thing. So you can say that is a simulation of the actual experience of riding a bike. Okay, are you getting? Given a feel, a give a given a experience, a virtual experience, which lets you to enjoy the feel, but you are not actually handling the things which is of actual real world. Okay, so in the same very similar manner, the way I have given you the example of riding a virtual simulated motorbike, will doing things of simulation for circuits. So this sessional, although we are calling it in general as a simulation lab, more precisely, this is a laboratory which should be called as a circuit simulation lab. Okay, so if you have done your basic electronics lab or basic electrical lab in your previous semesters, you must have handled breadboards over which you arrange the resistors, capacitors, diodes, the transistors, the power supplies, all these things to complete a circuit, and you then measure the performance of that whatever circuit you have designed by using different measuring instruments, your multimeter, your CRO, all these things. So at that time, while you are performing the experiments with circuits in a physical laboratory, where we are actually handling a diode, you are actually handling a resistor, that was a real thing because you were able to see, you have to you could hold it, you could fix it by your fingers. So you are actually holding the resistor, you are actually holding your BJT or diode. The power supplies could be actually connected. So I was telling that was a simulation. That motorcycle that you ride in the gaming point on the in the some in some of the malls is a simulated version of a real bike. Okay, so the similar thing we are going to do in this lab session, in this sessional, for the circuits. Okay, so we will be simulating the circuits, है ना? We'll be simulating the circuits. We'll design a circuit. In most of the experiments, there are 8 experiments in this sessional, and in all the experiments, you will be designing a circuit. You will be asked to perform something. You have to design a circuit for certain performance, and on the basis of the specified task, you have to design the circuit. You will design the circuit. For designing a circuit, you do not need to go to a lab. The designing of a circuit can be done on pen and paper with whatever theoretical knowledge you have, whatever mathematical models you know, whatever mathematical expressions you know, to how to relate the circuit parameters with the performance measures. Agar tumko pata hai, then you can design a circuit with pen and paper and with the basic theoretical knowledge. But how will you test your design? You'll be testing the design in a by use by the simulation. सिमुलेशन में क्या करोगे? जो सर्किट तुमने डिजाइन किया है, जो भी सर्किट पैरामीटर्स तुमने चूज किया है, नहीं हम रेजिस्टेंस इस वैल्यू का लेंगे, पावर सप्लाई इस वैल्यू का लेंगे, और कैपेसिटर इतने वैल्यू का लेंगे, है ना, और हम इस वे में, इस अरेंजमेंट में इनको कनेक्ट करेंगे टू कंप्लीट द सर्किट, एंड वी विल मेजर द आउटपुट अक्रॉस दिस सर्किट कंपोनेंट. सो दिस इज द थिंग यू हैव डिसाइडेड इन योर डिजाइन पार्ट. सो व्हेन विल द टाइम विल कम व्हेन यू विल वांट टू टेस्ट द डिजाइन, वेदर माय डिजाइन सर्किट इज वर्किंग इन द वे आई वांट द सर्किट टू वर्क, इफ इट इज एक्चुअली वर्किंग और नॉट, हाउ विल यू टेस्ट इट? द टेस्टिंग ऑफ द थिंग कैन बी डन आइदर ऑन द सिमुलेशन विच वी आर गोइंग टू डू हियर इन दिस सेशनल, और अदरवाइज यू कुड गो बाय द कन्वेंशनल वे, द ट्रेडिशनल वे, दैट इज अरेंजिंग द सर्किट्स ऑन द ब्रेडबोर्ड और ऑन अ पीसीबी टू मेकअप द सर्किट, द डिजाइन सर्किट, एंड देन यू कैन टेस्ट देयर. सो हम वो जो हम उसको रियली नहीं करके, हम किसी ब्रेडबोर्ड पे या पीसीबी पे इम्प्लीमेंट नहीं करके, विल डू इट इन अ इन द सिमुलेशन सॉफ्टवेयर. सो बेसिकली वी विल बी सिमुलेटिंग द डिजाइंड सर्किट ऑन द सिमुलेशन सॉफ्टवेयर, एंड द सिमुलेशन सॉफ्टवेयर आर डिजाइंड इन सच ए वे, द सर्किट सिमुलेशन सॉफ्टवेयर आर डिजाइंड इन सच ए वे दैट इट गिव्स यू ए फील दैट यू आर एक्चुअली ऑपरेटिंग ऑन अ ब्रेडबोर्ड ओनली. द लुक एंड फील ऑफ सर्किट सिमुलेशन सॉफ्टवेयर आर सच दैट दे विल मेक यू, दे विल गिव यू अ फील ऑफ like you are actually implementing the circuit by arranging the circuit components and completing the circuit on a breadboard. Everybody have seen the breadboard, right? In the basic electrical or basic electronics lab. Have you seen the breadboard? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then the similar look and feel will be provided to you by the simulation software, the circuit simulation software. Okay, simulation software are for different applications. The simulation, even the civil and mechanical people are doing and testing the things in simulation software before they actually do it in physical world. Suppose मैं एक example दे रहा हूँ in a very general manner. किसी को कोई एक civil engineer है, okay? तो वो एक design बनाया है कि हम इस तरह का material use करेंगे, bricks. का स्ट्रेंथ इतना होना चाहिए, डायमेंशन इतना होना चाहिए, इतना ऊंचाई का पिलर बनाएंगे, दो पिलर के बीच में डिस्टेंस इतना होना चाहिए, है ना. सो डिफरेंट थिंग्स दैट आर रिक्वायर्ड, सारे मेजरमेंट्स वो डिजाइन कर लिया पेन एंड पेपर, थियोरिटिकल नॉलेज इस्तेमाल करके. तो क्या वो एक्चुअली जाके वो पेन एंड पेपर का जो डिजाइन है एक्चुअली जाके इम्प्लीमेंट कर देगा? क्या पता वो जब एक्चुअली उसको डिजाइन को, डिजाइन में अगर कुछ प्रॉब्लम हुआ होगा तो अगर वो एक्चुअली सीमेंट और ईट और पिलर्स से खड़ा कर देगा छड़ लगा के, तो इट मे नॉट वर्क, द ब्रिज मे कोलैप्स. सो इन नाउ डेज व्हाट वी डू, मोस्ट ऑफ द इंजीनियर्स व्हाट वी डू, आफ्टर द डिजाइन फेज इज ओवर, आफ्टर द डिजाइन फेज इज ओवर, दे सिमुलेट इट ऑन सम सिमुलेशन सॉफ्टवेयर. सो सिविल इंजीनियर्स विल ऑल्सो बी हैविंग सम सिमुलेशन सॉफ्टवेयर वेर दे कैन implement their design in a simulation software. If the simulation software confirms that yes, this design is going to work fine, the performance measures are so satisfactory, then with that simulation results, jab wo satisfactory results de deta hai software, tab wo us design ko leke ab real world mein usko implement karne ke liye jayega. He will order for whatever, kitna dimension ka chhad chahiye, kitna कौन सा सीमेंट चाहिए, कितना चाहिए, विच डायमेंशन का ईंट चाहिए, पिलर का लेंथ कितना हो चाहिए, होना चाहिए, दैट देन ओनली ही विल डू इट इन द रियल वर्ल्ड. सो बेसिक, क्योंकि अब वो सिमुलेशन में वेरीफाई कर चुका है कि द डिजाइन इज गोइंग टू वर्क वेल एंड गुड, देन ही हैज अ बेटर कॉन्फिडेंस दैट जब मैं रियल वर्ल्ड में इसको करूंगा तो इट विल डू वेल. लेकिन अगर वो डिजाइन फेज के बाद डायरेक्टली अगर वो रियल वर्ल्ड में जाता है, हो सकता है कोई डिजाइन में गड़बड़ी होने के कारण ब्रिज कोलैप्स कर जाएगा और उसका बहुत सारे रिसोर्सेस वेस्ट हो जाएंगे. तो सो ये जो रिस्क है उसको रिड्यूस करने के लिए, टू रिड्यूस दिस रिस्क ऑफ फेल्योर, है ना.
एक्सक्यूज मी सर.
हाँ हेलो
सर, योर वॉइस इज नॉट क्लियर.
ओके,
इट इज ब्रेकिंग इन बिटवीन एंड
ओके, वेन एवर इट ब्रेक्स जस्ट इन्फॉर्म मी. ओके, इज इट ऑडिबल नाउ?
Yes sir, now it is clear.
Okay, so in order to reduce the risk of a failed implementation of a design, you know, After design, we go for a simulation stage, and then after only we go for the actual implementation on the real world. So हम जैसे सिविल इंजीनियर का इंजीनियरिंग का एग्जाम्पल दिया हूँ, हमारे सर्किट्स, हमारे इलेक्ट्रिकल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स के केस में क्या है, सपोज हमने एक सर्किट डिजाइन किया है, लेट्स से वी हैव डिजाइंड अ एम्पलीफायर. सो एम्पलीफायर डिजाइन करने के लिए हमको क्या क्या चाहिए होता है, वी नीड सम डीसी पावर सप्लाईज टू पावर अप द एम्पलीफायर, वी नीड सम रजिस्टर्स, वी नीड सम एक्टिव डिवाइसेस, सेमीकंडक्टर डिवाइसेस, है ना, बीजेटी चाहिए या एफईटी चाहिए, है ना, यू हैव ऑलरेडी डिजाइंड व्हिच बीजेटी यू आर गोइंग टू टेक हेल्प ऑफ, व्हिच एफईटी और व्हाट व्हिच एफईटी यू आर गोइंग टू मेक यूज ऑफ. So you have arranged these circuit components in a certain way. So हो सकता है तुम्हारे डिजाइन जब तुम कर रहे थे पेन पेपर में कैलकुलेशन करके रेजिस्टेंस का वैल्यू निकाले, कैपेसिटेंस का वैल्यू निकाले, पावर सप्लाई का वैल्यू निकाले, हो सकता है कोई तुमसे कुछ मिस्टेक हो गया होगा. तो जब तुम सीधे ब्रेडबोर्ड पे काम करने जाओगे तो इट मे नॉट वर्क. अब पता चला कि अरे रेजिस्टेंस का वैल्यू तो इतना नहीं होना चाहिए, उतना होना चाहिए, तो फिर यू विल अगेन गो टू द मार्केट एंड गेट द रिक्वायर्ड रेजिस्टेंस वैल्यू. Required value of resistance, or you will search your stock. These kinds of problems may arise. So, तुम क्या करोगे? It's the better way to not going directly to the breadboard or PCB. First of all, whatever design you have done, whatever circuit design you have done, you will first apply it, implement it on some simulation software. Then you can test there. Is it performing well? Yes. If it is performing well, then we will go for the PCB stage or the breadboard. Breadboard is also a temporary. Then you will go for the PCB design. Or otherwise, if something is problem, so you will relook your design. कहाँ पे गड़बड़ी हुआ है? Which component has to be something else or somewhat other value, so that my design works well. So you will revisit your design and you will try to get it correct. Then the redesigned thing, the new design, the modified design, you will again put it into simulator. Okay, then you will test. हाँ, अब अगर अच्छा काम कर रहा है, then you will go for the PCB stage. So this is how we proceed for circuit design and testing. So we have three phases anyway. For circuit implementation, you have three stages you should remember. That is circuit design, then testing. And testing mein phir do parts hai. You can test it either on simulation or breadboard. So if the simulation mein test karna aasan hai or it is more easier. So you will in our case we will testing it in the simulation software. Then we will go to the PCB design, जहाँ पे हम लोग एक्चुअली सर्किट कंपोनेंट्स को मार्केट से लाएंगे और उसको PCB सजाएंगे in the design manner, and then we'll try to measure its performance by using the different performance measurement devices. Okay, so this is the way. So anyway, in this entire sessional, we are not going to do the PCB design, or we'll not be implementing it in the breadboard. We'll basically stop at the simulation stage. So we'll design a circuit and we'll test the circuit on the simulation software. So that is what we are going to do. So in all the experiments I'm trying to show here, there are 8 experiments in this sessional. And in all the experiments, you will have to have 2 parts. Okay. In first part, you will do in the first phase. Whatever specification for the circuit is given, according to that you will design the circuit. You will be designing the circuit. Then once you have the designed circuit, designing the circuit, what it means? It means that you will make sure what are the circuit components you are going to require, how much value of resistance, how much capacitance, how much inductance, how much of power supply, in which manner they should be arranged to complete the circuit, and where we'll be applying the input, where we'll be observing the output. ये सारे चीजों को जो तय करना होता है. So that is the design part. So once you have made the design, you will go for the testing phase. So there you will be testing your design, whether my design circuit is working the way I want this circuit to work or not, if it is working in the same manner or not. So you will, in that phase, in the testing phase, you will be testing the designed circuit. So for the testing purpose, you will use the simulations, the circuit simulation software. Okay, so what is the other way of testing the circuit, design circuit? The other way is testing it on breadboard. Okay, so testing could be done either using simulation or it can be done on the breadboard. So testing the circuit using the breadboard requires arranging the circuit components in the way you have decided in the design phase, and then actually measuring the performance using the measuring instruments. So that is how you do it on breadboard. But on simulation, in the simulation, if you choose for simulation, testing by simulation, you will not require the circuit components. Each and every circuit components will be not be required. You will not require any physical wires or circuit components or power supplies. You will launch the software. You do the things on the software only, drag and drop, connect the components, and you will test it there only. Okay, I will show some demonstrations how the things can be done on simulation in a very simple manner. Okay, so once you know simulation, you will always prefer for the testing by simulation. Okay, it is so easy. Testing by simulation is so easy that you will always prefer for simulation rather than doing it on breadboard. So once this testing phase is over, then only you go for implementing the circuit on a PCB. Okay, on a PCB board. Then PCB board is a permanent thing, a fixed thing. Once you have implemented it on the PCB, you cannot, somebody cannot tamper it so easily. Okay. So this is the final thing. Okay. So the mobile phones, the smartphones, the optical mouse, all have a circuit, and the circuit has been implemented on a PCB. So that is the final thing. After this design and testing phase is over, the ultimate form of the circuit is on the PCB. So we are not going to go to the PCB stage for the time while in this sessional, but we'll be stopping at this testing by simulation phase. Okay. My voice is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let me tell you what are the experiments we are going to perform. Okay. So the first experiment will be upon filters, the frequency selective circuits. What are filters? Filters are the frequency selective circuits. So the gain of the filters are dependent upon the frequency. So whatever input signal you provide to the filter, the signal may have multiple frequencies or whatever frequency it has. So how much gain the filter will provide to that frequency depends upon that frequency only. So that is why the filter is called frequency selective. Okay. Different frequency is provided with different amount of gains and phase shifts. The filters are such circuits which treats different frequencies in different manners in terms of the gain and in terms of phase shift. That's why filters are called frequency selective circuits. So we'll try to design low pass filter, we'll try to design high pass filter, and then test it. We'll also go for band pass filter. So that is the first experiment. In the second experiment will be what it is. It is half wave, full wave rectifiers. Okay, so half wave and full wave rectifiers will try to design and then test. Yes. What are the types of full wave rectifiers?
Well, bridge type and
array. One is
bridge type and center tap.
Yes, there are. Right. So there are two types of full wave rectifiers. One is bridge type full wave rectifier, and another is center tapped full wave rectifiers. So we'll try to design and test three types of rectifiers. One is simple half wave rectifier, and the two full wave rectifiers. That is the bridge type full wave rectifier and the center tapped full wave rectifier. We'll try to design and test these rectifiers. And then we can compare. We can do a relative comparison. Which one is better in what manner? Okay. After testing, we will be able to decide. So we'll do it in the second experiment. Then, the third experiment will be using a Jenner diode. Jenner diode is a special diode. Okay. So voltage regulator is used in most of the appliances that you use in your home. So what is a voltage regulator? We'll discuss there. You have already studied this voltage regulator thing in your basic electronics. Okay, you have also studied about half wave and full wave rectifiers. You also have studied your low pass and high pass and band pass filters. These all circuits you have already studied in the basic electronics subject. So we'll just revisit those theoretical things which we have already studied, and we'll try to bring it to the laboratory. We'll try to realize. Okay. So we'll try to design voltage regulator in the third experiment using the Jenner diode. So these three experiments are related. So what it does? This is design and study of common emitter BJT fixed bias configuration for suitable operating point in an amplifier application. We already know that BJT has basically two applications. The BJT, bipolar junction transistor, can be used either to design a switch, or it can be used to design a amplifier. So these are the So a BJT can be used either to design a switch or to design a amplifier. So in this experiment, the fourth experiment, we will use a BJT and we'll fix the operating point of the BJT by using some biasing circuit, so that the operating point is located at somewhere it is good for amplifier application. So we'll put the operating point in which region of the output characteristics? Yes. So for amplifier application, we will fix the
active region.
Active region. So by using the biasing circuit, we'll try to put the operating point of the BJT in the active region. Because in active region only, when the operating point is placed, it can be used for amplifier application. So the fourth experiment is all about fixing the operating point in the active region. Okay, so that is the thing which is to be done in the fourth experiment. In the fifth experiment, we have whatever operating point we have fixed it. Fourth experiment, you will use that operating point to design a amplifier. So amplifier will be realized in the fifth experiment. So we'll test here whether if the operating point which we have done in the active region is good enough to realize an amplifier or not. We'll give a certain sinusoidal input of certain frequency at the input, and we'll try to fetch out the output. If the output is coming out amplified or not. Okay, we'll try to take it in the fifth experiment. Then in the sixth experiment, it is all about designing an oscillator. Okay, the sixth experiment speaks about designing a oscillator. You know what a oscillator is? Anybody? Yes, just try to reply. What is an oscillator? Okay, I'm telling you. An oscillator is a circuit which can generate a signal of certain frequency. Okay, so what is a oscillator? It's a kind of signal generator. Okay, oscillator is a circuit which generates a signal. Okay, it's a signal generator. And when I say oscillator, it generates a signal of certain frequency. Of certain frequency. So let that frequency be some F0. Will denote. So a oscillator is always designed in a manner that it oscillates at us. It gives you signals oscillating at a certain frequency. Okay. Suppose for some device to work, you need to have a signal of, let's say, 1 kilohertz. So where will you get this 1 kilohertz signal in that circuit? So what will do? You will have to have an oscillator in that system. A oscillator circuit must be a part of that system. So oscillator, what it will do? It will generate a signal of the right frequency. So what does it has? Oscillator, what design aspect does the oscillator have? When we talk about designing oscillator, so what we do, we are specified of how much frequency we are intended to produce out of that oscillator. Let's say we are said that we want a signal of 1 kilohertz. So to degenerate this 1 kilohertz signal, what are the circuit components that must be the part of at the output of the hertz oscillating signal, 1 kilohertz signal. Okay, so that is the design part. And if you have already studied in the basic electronics, an oscillator is nothing but an amplifier with feedback. Your oscillator is nothing but an amplifier with feedback. So since the previous experiment you have already designed an amplifier, you will use this amplifier designed amplifier circuit. The design of the amplifier circuit over in the fifth experiment, you will use the same amplifier circuit to design this oscillator. Okay, so out of this fifth experiment, you must have gotten an amplifier. You must have gotten an amplifier. Okay, to which a V input could be given and V output can be fetched out. So you will use the same amplifier to design the oscillator. So how the oscillator is designed? Oscillator is designed with the help of a amplifier only. So this is the feedback loop. So this is the input of the amplifier. This is the amplifier of gain A. This is the input of the amplifier. This is the output of the amplifier. Feedback means what? Some part of the output signal is fed back to the input. Of the amplifier. That is the feedback amplifier. So such a circuit will be realized in the sixth experiment. So that this feedback amplifier works as a signal generator, so that we can call it as a oscillator. And which kind of feedback is used for designing oscillator? Positive feedback or negative feedback? Anybody? Just reply. Oscillator is nothing but an amplifier with feedback. But again, the feedback can be either positive feedback or negative feedback. So which kind of feedback is useful for designing oscillator? Positive feedback or negative feedback? Anybody just reply.
Sir, positive.
Yes. The positive feedback is used for designing oscillator circuits. Negative feedback is used for getting better amplifiers. Okay, whatever amplifier you have here, if you'll apply negative feedback to it, this the overall amplifier with feedback will be a better amplifier. Okay, an amplifier with negative feedback gives a better amplifier. But positive feedback is useful for designing oscillator circuits. Okay, so we'll apply positive feedback. Of course, some other constraints has to be maintained so that the positive feedback with the amplifier gives you a amplifier. Okay, we have a principle called Barkhausen's principle. You must have studied while you must be studying the oscillator feedback and oscillators in the basic electronics subject in the previous semesters. Okay, so Barkhausen's principle must be satisfied by the amplifier positive feedback so that it works as an oscillator. So we'll see there. Okay, so that is all about designing a oscillator in the sixth experiment. Then in the seventh experiment, we'll do something, some experiments on communication in seventh and eighth experiment. So we'll design a amplitude modulation transmitter. Okay, we'll design a transmitter system which will produce a signal which is amplitude modulated. Okay. At the block level, I can say that we'll design a system to which we'll be providing a message signal M of T and a carrier signal C of T. Okay, this is all about the seventh experiment, design and study of amplitude modulation using analog multiplier IC AD633JN. So in this experiment, what we are going to do, we'll give a message signal and carrier signal to this system, and the system must be producing to you a amplitude modulated signal S of T. So what is inside this block, we are going to design it in the seventh experiment. So what should be the circuit design of this block? I have the block representation over here, and this is the block representation. So what circuit should comprise inside this block so that the system represented by this block works as an amplitude modulator? Given a message signal and a carrier signal, it should produce an amplitude modulated signal. Okay, and to design this amplitude modulator circuit, we'll use a component which is called as analog multiplier. And it comes in the form of a IC. The IC name is AD633JN. So we'll use this analog multiplier to design this amplitude modulator circuit. That is all about your seventh experiment. In the eighth experiment, it is the design and study of amplitude demodulation using analog multiplier, the same analog multiplier, that is AD633JN. It comes in the form of a IC. So we'll use the same analog multiplier to demodulate the signal S of T. So we'll design a block which is analog demodulator, to which we will be giving the amplitude modulated signal. This S of T will be given to this amplitude demodulator signal, amplitude demodulator system. Okay, this is a system which is amplitude demodulator we are going to design, to which we will be providing this signal S of T. What is S of T? S of T is the amplitude modulated signal. And what we are expecting at the output of the amplitude demodulator? We are expecting some version of message signal. We are expecting the message signal at the output of the amplitude demodulator. So we'll try to design this the circuit which should represent this amplitude demodulator block in the eighth experiment. Okay, are you following me? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
sir.
Okay. So these are okay. These are all the 8 experiments. I've tried to give a view of what all are the experiments we are going to perform in this sessional, the laboratory, which is named as circuit simulation laboratory. These 8 experiments has to be done. Okay. Now we are now in a position where we understand what is circuit simulation after all, and then we are already at a point where we are clear what all are the experiments we are trying to do in this laboratory sessional. So now let us move to the software we are going to use. Okay, we'll be using a software called Multisim. Okay, this is the interface that you get for the Multisim simulation software. Are you able to see the screen, the window for the Multisim software?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Multisim is a software given to you by a company called National Instruments, NI. You can simulate analog circuits. You can simulate digital circuits also. Okay. If you are interested in designing and testing digital circuits, then also you can simulate it using this Multisim software. You must be studying your network analysis, right, in this semester?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Network analysis and synthesis. In there also, you will be studying different circuits, different circuit theorems. Using those theorems, you can develop different circuits for whatever purposes. And those circuits can be tested using this software. Okay. So this Multisim is going to help you as a electronics engineer for a long time to come. है ना, बहुत दिन तक तुमको काम आता रहेगा. जब तक तुम इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजीनियर हो तब तक तुमको मल्टीसिम सॉफ्टवेयर हेल्प करेगा. जो सर्किट्स तुम डिजिटल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स में पढ़ने वाले हो उसको भी तुम टेस्ट कर सकते हो. ओके, सो दिस सॉफ्टवेयर इज गोइंग टू हेल्प यू फॉर ए लॉन्ग टाइम टू कम. ओके, जो भी तुम वहां पर थियोरेटिकल सर्किट्स पढ़ते हो समझते हो, यू कैन एक्चुअली simulate it over here and see its performance, understand it in a better way. How it works can be more clear if you use these kind of softwares in addition to whatever you study from the book. Tum kitab se jo padhte ho, apne faculties se jo sunte ho, usko jab tum implement karoge kisi is tarah ke simulation software mein, to us subject ko, us topic ko tum better understand kar paoge. You will be able to better understand the topic. So let me give you a demo where I can tell you how this software can be used to simulate simple circuits. So we'll start off with simple circuits, and then later on we'll in today's session I will not be giving you any task. Okay, there is no task for you. You will just see and try to learn. Okay, so there are different, this is a toolbox on the top. Okay, here also the measuring instruments are available on the right panel, right vertical panel. Here you can see this is multimeter. Here you have function generator. Here you have wattmeter. So these are different measuring instruments that is arranged in my right vertical panel. Oscilloscope, 4-channel oscilloscope, Bode plotter, frequency counter, word generator, logic converter, logic analyzer. So these are different measuring instruments that is arranged in this vertical panel. So some here also I have a panel which gives me different circuit components. This is for placing a source. This is for placing a basic circuit components. This is for placing a diode. This is for placing a transistor. Okay, likewise, there are different circuit components arranged on this horizontal panel. Whenever I want to start a new design, I will go to file and then click on new. So it will give me a new seamless file where I can put my design. So also you can access different circuit components from this panel and the measuring instruments from this panel. The better way to access and use the components and measuring instruments is from this place option. There is a place option here, over here. Okay, and place, and I have a component. When I click on component, the entire component library is in front of me in form of this particular window. Suppose here you will see this is the database option. What I can choose from is my database, corporate database, and user database. So I'm getting it okay with this master database. Okay, so I have groups of components, and the group can be selected from this drop down menu. Suppose I want let's say some register. Suppose so I will choose basic. Under basic, I will be having the basic circuit components like resistors, capacitors, inductors. So once I click basic, okay, so under basic group I have all these circuit components. So let me choose a resistor. So let me choose a resistance of 1k. So I have 1k over here. I press on OK. So I get a resistor over here, which I can click on the virtual breadboard. This is the virtual breadboard, right? The background with dots over here is the virtual breadboard. On the virtual breadboard, I can place this resistor by clicking on the breadboard. So once I have clicked on this virtual breadboard, the resistance gets placed on the virtual breadboard. So let me get another resistor. So I have the resistor is already selected. 1K I have selected and then pressed OK. So I get another resistor. So let me get some power source. So to choose a power source from group option, group menu, and let me choose sources. From the sources, let me choose a power source, DC power source, and then press OK so that I get a DC power source over here. Okay, so let me do a simple circuit. So if I want to make interconnections among these circuit components, I will click on one of the terminals of this DC power supply. I have pressed the left button of the mouse, and I will leave the left button only when I have a terminal to which I have to connect have reached. So I have reached to this point. I will reach out the cursor to this point, and then I will release the left button, or I will able to again click. Okay, then this wire, red colored wire, click appears and connects these two terminals of this DC power supply and this resistor. Suppose I want to connect these two components. So I will click on this terminal, and then I will get the second click on over here. If I want to connect this terminal and this terminal, I will single click over here. I have released the button. If I want to have a turn over here, at this point I want to have a turn. So I will click over here, click and release. So I will get a turn over here. I want to make a turn over here. So again I click, and I want to connect it over here. So whenever a connection is feasible, a red bubble appears near the terminal. If you can see, a red bubble appears. So once the bubble appears, that means the connection has can be done. So I will put a left click. So this wire gets connected. So as I connected the DC power source 12 volt to two resistances 1 kilo ohm each. Dono ek ek kilo ohm ka. That can be done. I can do these things. Okay. I can click on the wire and stretch. I can even rotate these circuit components. If I'll right click, rotate 90 degree. So I can do this also. Right click, rotate 90 degree. I can do this also. Okay. Even after the connection has been made, I can change the position of the circuit components. I can rotate, I can move left or right, up or down. Okay, I can, these things can be done. So if this is the circuit, by doing some math on my pen, with my pen and paper, I can always calculate how much current is going to flow in this circuit. You can do it simply. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I'll just calculate how much current is going to flow from this.
6 milliampere.
Okay. Now, in this simulation, I'll be able to. Okay, 6 milliampere. So, in this simulation software, I will just verify that your theoretical calculation, which is giving you a current which says that the current of 6 milliampere must flow in this circuit, if it is correct or not. Okay, so we can check it, we can test it in this simulation software. Okay, so let me do it. So what I'll do, I will get a multimeter from this measuring instruments panel over right side. I will get the multimeter. I will click on the multimeter and I will bring it over here. And since I am interested in measuring the current, I need an ammeter actually.
Yes.
And multimeter is such a measuring instrument that can be used as an ammeter, it can be used also as a voltmeter by choosing the required mode of operation of the multimeter. Okay, so if I'm using the multimeter to work as an ammeter, I should connect it in series or in parallel in the circuit.
Series,
right. So what I'll do, I'll connect the multimeter in series. So, and that's what I'm trying to do it here, over here. Okay. So I have connected the multimeter in series to this circuit. Now I have to select the mode. To select the mode, I will double click on this multimeter. I will double click on this multimeter. So here the mode comes. I want to do the current measurement. So I will choose the ampere. V means voltage. Ohm means resistance measurement. dB means decibel measurement. So different modes can be selected for the multimeter. Since I am interested in measuring the current, I am choosing the ampere mode. And since I'm dealing with DC current in this circuit, I have chosen the DC mode. Otherwise, if I must be, if main AC current se deal kar raha hota, I would have chosen this AC mode. But no, here I'm interested in DC current. So DC and current. So this multimeter in the way I have selected the modes will operate to measure the DC current in this circuit. So once I have selected the modes, I can get rid of it. Okay. Once I have arranged the circuit, I will go for this run button. This is the run button. Run button, when clicked, it starts the simulation. Okay, up till now you have just implemented the circuit on this virtual breadboard. You have not yet simulated it. So once you run this, you press this run button, the circuit takes effect. Okay, the circuit takes effect. Now if I'll double click on this multimeter, it shows minus 6 milliampere. Why it shows minus 6 milliampere? Tell me, anybody can tell? Who can tell?
Opposite direction of current.
Why you have calculated 6 milliampere, but it is showing minus 6 milliampere. What is the reason?
The positive terminal negative mein lagaye source ka.
So you just change the terminal, then it will show 6 milliampere.
Okay. The direction of current in this loop is from in this direction, right? The direction is in this direction. The direction of current is in this direction. But the positive terminal is connected to the negative terminal of the DC power supply, and negative terminal of the DC power, of the multimeter is connected through the resistance through the positive terminal. So if you want to see in terms of flow of positive charges in this loop, you must connect it in the opposite way. So I will just stop simulation. I will delete the wires. I will rotate it or flip it, flip horizontally. Okay, flip vertically. So now it is flipped vertically. No, it will not work. Flip vertically, flip horizontally. Now it is okay. Now that positive terminal is on the right hand side. Okay, so when this positive current will enter, is connected to the positive end of this multimeter, and the negative end of this power supply is connected to the negative end of this multimeter, now it will give me the 6 milliampere which you have calculated. Now let me rerun this simulation, and now you see it is showing me 6 milliampere current that is flowing in this direction. Okay, so this is a very simple simulation which I have performed to demonstrate how this simulation software works. So you have first arranged the circuit, you calculated the design value of current that should flow in this circuit, and you verified it by testing it on this software. This is what we have done just now. जो तुम्हारा 6 milliampere तुम calculate करके निकाले हो, that is the design value of current. That means अगर इस तरह का circuit arrangement है तो इतना current यहां से flow करना चाहिए. तुमने कहीं पर ना breadboard पे गए, ना तुम software में try किए, तुमने अपना मैथमेटिकल मॉडलिंग जो अभी तक समझे सर्किट्स के विषय में तुमको पता है उसको यूज करके वो वैल्यू तुम कैलकुलेट किए, दैट इज द डिजाइन वैल्यू. यू चेक्ड द डिजाइन वैल्यू टू मैच विद दिस एक्सपेरिमेंटल वैल्यू. ऑल्दो यू आर परफॉर्मिंग द एक्सपेरिमेंट हियर ऑन अ सिमुलेशन सॉफ्टवेयर, आफ्टर ऑल दिस इज एन एक्सपेरिमेंट, सो यू वेरीफाइड योर डिजाइन वैल्यू, योर थियोरेटिकल डिजाइन वैल्यू विद द एक्सपेरिमेंटल वैल्यू, एंड इट केम exactly same. Okay, so this will be the similar will be the approach for whatever experiments you are going to perform in this session. Okay, let us tumhara kitna baje tak hai lab by the way? Hello,
do
baje tak. Okay, we'll not continue up to and we can continue up half an hour. Okay. This is an introduction lab. So we'll continue half an hour more. So हम कुछ और चीजें एक्सप्लोर करते हैं इस मल्टी सिम सॉफ्टवेयर पे, हम लोग क्या क्या और कर सकते हैं. Let us see. So this is not about any experiment. This is just an overview, introduction to this multi sim circuit simulation software. Okay. Let us stop this simulation which was just running. I will try to do a something different thing. Let me place it. Okay, anyway, we have used the multimeter in the current mode, DC current mode. Let me use the multimeter in the voltage mode. That will be a good thing to do. So let me disconnect the wires. I'm deleting the wires. Okay. I'm rotating it. Okay. I'm trying to flip it. So the positive terminal goes to it. And I will connect the multimeter in parallel to the R2 resistance. Okay. This is the complete circuit, and I have connected the multimeter across the R2 resistance, and I have selected the voltage measuring mode, DC voltage measuring mode, and then okay. Now you just tell me how much voltage is expected to be shown by this voltmeter, because this multimeter is now working as a DC voltmeter. So tell me how much voltage should appear.
6 volt.
6 volt.
Okay, let me run the simulation.
6 volt.
And check. We'll see that 6 volt. Okay, so we have used the multimeter in both current, DC current measuring mode and DC voltage measuring mode. Okay, we have done things with multimeter. Now let us do something different. Stop this simulation. I'm deleting this measuring instrument, which was your multimeter. I'm going to replace this.
Sir, delete kyun ki kal sir instrument ha?
Just pressing the delete button in your keyboard.
Okay sir.
Okay. In this virtual breadboard, control C to copy, control V to paste, delete button, pressing the delete button to delete. These things work. Suppose I want a resistance, same resistance again, let's say. So, अगर मैं इसको सिलेक्ट कर लूं और कंट्रोल सी प्रेस किया हूं मैं, ठीक है, अगर मैं यहां पर और एक डिफरेंट जगह में क्लिक करके इफ आई पुट कंट्रोल वी, इट वर्क्स. आई नीड नॉट गो टू दिस प्लेस कंपोनेंट्स एंड चूजिंग द रेजिस्टर्स फ्रॉम दिस लाइब्रेरी. ओके, अगर मेरे पास ऑलरेडी एक कंपोनेंट है यहां पर, तो मैं कंट्रोल सी कंट्रोल वी करके भी अपना समय बचा सकता हूं. Okay, and this comes with a different name, R3. So this saves time. So control C, control V, delete, all these things work. Okay, agar tum kisi component ko choose karke arrow button se bhi tum left ya right karna chaho to kar sakte hain. Your arrow buttons will help you to up, down, left, right. Okay, so whatever familiar keyboard way of doing things you were already doing for your usual things, most of those things works here also in this software. Control Z matlab kya hota hai? Undo. To undo bhi yahan kaam karta hai. Control Z kar raha hu, dekho maine control Z press kar raha hu, jo main kiya tha pichla 3-4 step wo revert ho gaya. Control Y bhi kaam karta hai. Control Y kya hota hai? Undo ka opposite, aage badhna hai. This is the manner I moved the component, resistance component. So control Z and control Y also works. Okay. So मैं क्या करने वाला था? Let me do a thing with oscilloscope. Oscilloscope is used to visualize time varying signals. So let me replace this power source with a AC source. I will go to place component signal voltage sources AC voltage source. Okay. When I press OK, I will get a source which is signal voltage source. Which kind of voltage source? AC voltage source. Okay. So I will get a AC voltage source which I can place anywhere in this virtual breadboard. Once I click somewhere, it gets fixed here, there. Okay. Now I can make the connections clicking, 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 clicking. So I have made the circuit. Now I want to observe a waveform across this R2 resistance. So what I'll do, I'll get a oscilloscope from this measuring instruments panel. So I also have function generator over here in this panel. Function generator is there. Function generator is not a measuring instrument. It is a generator. It's not a measuring device, but it is a signal generator. But still it is placed over in this panel. So what I require for now is a oscilloscope. So I'm searching for oscilloscope. So here I get this oscilloscope. I click here so that I can place it over somewhere in this virtual breadboard. So again here it's a two channel oscilloscope, channel A, channel B, very similar oscilloscope which we have used in the hardware laboratory, in the basic electronics or basic electronics lab, whatever dual trace CRO which you have used, a similar thing appears over here. There are two channels, channel A and channel B. There is a positive terminal for channel A, there is a negative terminal for channel A. There is a positive terminal for channel B, there is a negative terminal for channel B. So since I want to measure the voltage across this R2 resistance, let me connect the B channel across R2 resistance. Click, click, click. Okay. So another channel I have not used. I will later use this channel also. So once I have connected one channel, that is channel B of this oscilloscope across R2, let me run this simulation and see the waveform on the oscilloscope. Run. Now you can see the waveform appears over here. So this is the volt per division adjustment for channel B. This is the volt per division adjustment for channel A. So I have not provided any signal to channel A. So this is useless for time being. This channel adjustment, channel A voltage per division adjustment is useless for time being because I have not connected anything, any signal to channel A. So what is effective is channel B. Volt per division adjustment. So if you reduce the volt per division adjustment, the signal will look larger in shape, larger in size in the oscilloscope. You see? Okay. When I decrease the volt per division adjustment, the signal gets larger. If I increase the volt per division adjustment, when I increase, the signal gets smaller in appearance. Okay. You should always keep in mind that volt per division adjustment doesn't change the characteristic of the signal. It only changes the way you visualize it. You are basically zooming in and zooming out. Okay, this is what you do in this adjustment. Zooming in, zooming out. Okay. Okay, anyway. Here, if you want to observe this waveform in a more close manner, you need to pause the simulation so that the waveform doesn't just run in this continuous manner. It stops or it pauses so that you can observe it very closely. So I will pause this simulation over here. So I have paused the simulation. So whatever waveforms have passed, I can access to that part of the waveform moving this slider. So I am moving to the past waveforms. Okay. So this is time axis. On the x axis is the time axis, of course, and the y axis is your voltage axis. So for better visualization, I will reverse this plot. Reverse means the background will become white. Reverse, the background is black. Reverse, black background is white. So whichever is better for your visualization, जो तुमको देखने में अच्छा लगे, you can choose by reverse button. I prefer doing it with a white background because it saves ink when you try to print this waveform. जब तुम इसको पेपर में प्रिंट करोगे तो background रहेगा, तो it saves ink. नहीं तो पूरा background black रहेगा और तुम्हारा जो जेरो सुकान वाला बोलेगा, तुम इतना black ले हो, मेरा ink ज्यादा खर्चा हो गया, 5 की जगह 10. Okay. So that is not good. Even if you are spending your own printer's ink, it is good to have a white background so that you save ink. So if agar main isko volt per division kama deta hu, to the waveform will look larger. And I want to have a better in terms of time axis also. So I can choose the part, I can adjust the time per division adjustment also. If I decrease the time per division scale, the signal will be look, the signal will look expanded on the x-axis. But meanwhile, you must understand that while you are adjusting the time per division or voltage per division, you are not actually tempering the signal. You are not making any change to the signal itself. You are only changing the way the signal appears to you. It is as good as zooming in and zooming out. Okay, तुम किसी चीज को पास से देखो या दूर से देखो, it is like that. तुम किसी चीज को पास से देखो तो वो चीज बड़ा नहीं हो जाता है, जो चीज तुम किसी चीज को दूर से देखो तो वो चीज छोटा नहीं हो सकता है. It is only the way you perceive. तुम अगर कोई किसी चीज को अच्छे से देखना चाहते हो, you get closer to that. So when you are decreasing the volt per division, you are getting actually closer to it. The characteristic of the signal is not changing. Okay. Ye kabhi kabhi ye misconception reh jata hai, so you should not have that. Okay. Now here the signal says that it is 1 V peak and it is 1 kilohertz. Hello students, are you following me or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I thought I may not be audible and I may be speaking to the screen. Okay. Now let us just confirm in this oscilloscope how I can confirm that it is of 1 V peak and 1 kilohertz. Oscilloscope is a measuring instrument which you have used in the laboratory, and you already know that it is useful. It is so useful that you can actually measure the peak to peak voltage and the frequency of the signal of the waveform you are observing on the oscilloscope. So since this is a oscilloscope, although virtual, I should be able to measure the peak to peak voltage and measure the frequency of the signal by observing the waveform on the oscilloscope. So to do the thing, what I will do, I have two cursors over here. Okay, markers, you can say cursor or marker. This is marker 1 in red. This is marker 2 in blue. So the way I have selected the power source, it is 1V peak. And since I am observing it across this R2 resistance, how much voltage it should appear? If it is 1V peak, how much V peak should be here? Tell me. Yes. If this is 1V peak across R2 resistance, how much V peak should appear?
Half, sir.
0.5 V peak should appear. So what the this peak to 1 V peak, hai na? This is not peak to peak, this is V peak. What is V peak? From ground to one of the peaks, that difference in voltage is called V peak. What is peak to peak? From negative peak to positive peak, that is peak to peak. So this is 1 V peak, not peak to peak. So let me check. If this is this observed waveform is half V peak or not, because across R2 I should get half V peak. So I will place the marker over here, marker 1 over here. No, let me place marker 2 over the positive peak. Okay. And marker 1 at the zero crossing. Now you see, this is marker 2 position. So whatever voltage it registers, it is showing over here in this row. It shows 497.067 millivolt. This marker 1, wherever it intersects the waveform, it's over here. You have to place it. So, jahan par bhi isko intersect kar raha hai, that particular voltage, it shows in this row. It shows 5.165 millivolt. And the difference between the position of marker 2 and marker 1, that is T2 minus T1, is this much, 491.899 millivolt. So this is almost 0.5 volt. Yes or no? This is approximately 0.5 volt or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this is approximately 0.5 volt, which I expected to appear across this R2. Let me choose channel A also. Let me use channel A also. I have left the channel A of the oscilloscope. So let me get rid of this oscilloscope window. Channel A ko main kya karta hun? Iske saath connect kar deta hun. Source ke saath. In any circuit I design, I must place a reference ground. It is a good habit to place a reference ground for any circuit I design. And so to get the ground, I will stop this simulation from sources, power sources, ground. Okay. So I will place the ground, reference ground over here. And this potential should be your reference ground. So source is 1 V peak in reference to this point. Okay. So this output is getting measured with reference to this reference ground.
Sir, R2 is sorted.
R2 is sorted? No. Where it is sorted?
those two wires are this crossing.
Okay, okay, I got your doubt. This wire is not getting sorted with this wire. This is safely crossing, okay, safely crossing, crisscrossing this line. This wire is safely crisscrossing this line without getting interconnected. How you can say that? Whenever a connection is there, a bubble appears. You see there, you see here, a bubble is appearing over here.
Yes, sir.
A similar bubble is not over here. That means they are not interconnected.
Yes, sir.
Here we have a bubble. That means there is a connection. Here we have a bubble. That means there is a connection. Here we have a bubble. That means there is a connection. But here, although two wires crisscross each other, there is no bubble to be seen. That means they are not connected. They safely crisscross each other without getting interconnected. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Good question. Good thing to spot. Okay, good. Now, if I run this simulation and double click on this oscilloscope, I get two waveforms simultaneously. Pause this simulation. I go to the past waveforms. I can see. To better visualization, I put the scale to the same. Dono ko ek hi scale mein rakhta hu main. 500 millivolt idhar channel A wala ko bhi aur 500 millivolt channel B wale ko bhi. But now I am not able to identify which one is channel A, which is channel B. हाँ, अगर मैं magnitude compare करूँगा, क्योंकि दोनों का scale same है, तो बड़ा वाला वेवफॉर्म जरूर चैनल ए का है और छोटा वाला वेवफॉर्म जरूर चैनल बी का है. लेकिन स्टिल अगर मुझे मैग्नीट्यूड का इंफॉर्मेशन नहीं है, स्केल का इंफॉर्मेशन नहीं है, इट इज क्वाइट डिफिकल्ट टू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन विच इज इनपुट सिग्नल एंड विच इज द आउटपुट सिग्नल. सो टू सिंप्लीफाई दिस प्रॉब्लम, व्हाट आई कैन डू, आई विल स्टॉप द सिमुलेशन एंड चेंज द कलर ऑफ द वायर that goes to the positive terminal of channel A. तो मैं क्या करूंगा, इस वायर के ऊपर या इस वायर को कहीं पर भी क्लिक करूंगा जो पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल को गया है चैनल ए का, राइट क्लिक करूंगा एंड आई विल गो टू सेगमेंट कलर. सेगमेंट कलर, लेट मी चूज अ ब्लू कलर सो दैट द वायर दैट कनेक्ट्स to the positive terminal of channel A, which is coming from the positive terminal of the source, that appears blue. The wire gets blue. Resultantly, what will happen? Ki channel A ka corresponding jo signal hai, that signal also, the waveform also will look blue when I run the simulation. You see, I will pause the simulation. And when I see, I have fixed the same volt per division scale for channel A and channel B. So I can identify the bigger waveform which appears in blue is larger. The bigger waveform is corresponding to channel A and it is larger in magnitude. The smaller waveform, which is the waveform for the signal across, the voltage across R2 resistance, that is coming in red color and it is of smaller magnitude. हम magnitude of comparison तभी कर पाएंगे जब हम लोग दोनों का scale same रखे हों, तभी हम visual comparison कर पाएंगे कि कौन बड़ा है कौन छोटा है. अगर different scales पे रख दोगे you will not be able to see, दोनों waveform है यहाँ पर लेकिन पता नहीं चलेगा. तो तुम visual comparison तभी कर पाओगे जब तुम्हारा दोनों का वोल्ट पर डिवीजन के सेम हो. तो यू कैन इजीली डिस्टिंग्विश ब्लू वाला वेवफॉर्म तुम्हारा इन सोर्स का है और रेड वाला वेवफॉर्म तुम्हारा द वोल्टेज अक्रॉस R2 है. एंड हियर आल्सो यू कैन चेक द सोर्स सिग्नल 1 VPeak है या नहीं है. you place the marker T2 at the positive peak. You place the marker T1 at the zero crossing, close to zero crossing. Because you are doing it manually, you cannot be very precise. So how much precisely you can do, you try to do. Okay. So T2 marker is at peak, T1 marker is at the zero crossing. So T2 minus T1 for channel 1 you should check, and it is showing 951.772, which is almost 1 volt. So 1 V peak. So reference ground to the peak value, it is almost 1 volt peak. So which is 1 V peak. Are you getting? So this is how you are using the oscilloscope to observe and measure the amplitude or voltage, the V peak measurement or V peak to peak measurement. You can do it by using the markers on the oscilloscope in this way. अगर V peak to peak measure करना है, क्या करोगे? T1 marker को लाके negative peak पे डाल दोगे. Now you will check for channel A. So it means it is almost 2 volt. क्योंकि 1 volt peak to peak है, मतलब sorry 1 volt अगर V peak है, तो peak to peak क्या होगा? Twice of it, 2 V peak. Yes or no? So this is 2 volt peak. This is to specify this same 1 V peak signal only. This is how you can measure the V peak or V peak to peak using the oscilloscope. चाहे तुम ये R2 के across जो signal waveform है उसको तुम यहाँ पर trace कर रहे हो, या तुम source signal को as it is channel A पे trace कर रहे हो, दोनों केस में द फ्रीक्वेंसी इज सेम. यस और नो? दोनों के केस में फ्रीक्वेंसी हैज नॉट चेंज्ड. तो फ्रीक्वेंसी इज 1 किलोहर्ट्ज़ फॉर बोथ सिग्नल्स. हाउ कैन यू वेरीफाई दैट द फ्रीक्वेंसी इज 1 किलोहर्ट्ज़ यूजिंग द ऑसिलोस्कोप? यू प्लेस टू मार्कर्स एट टू जीरो क्रॉसिंग्स. ये नेगेटिव गोइंग वेवफॉर्म है, दूसरा नेगेटिव गोइंग वेवफॉर्म कहाँ है? माने एक टाइम पीरियड के इंटरवल पे दोनों मार्कर को प्लेस कर दो. यस सर. ये तुम्हारा नेगेटिव गोइंग वेवफॉर्म है, पॉजिटिव से नेगेटिव जा रहा था जीरो क्रॉसिंग. सो पॉजिटिव टू नेगेटिव जीरो क्रॉसिंग ये है, फिर दूसरा कंसेक्यूटिव पॉजिटिव टू नेगेटिव जीरो क्रॉसिंग ये है. नॉट प्लेस ओवर हियर. तो ये पॉजिटिव टू नेगेटिव जाने वाला पॉइंट जीरो क्रॉसिंग है, दूसरा पॉजिटिव टू नेगेटिव जाने वाला जीरो क्रॉस है. तो यहाँ के बीच में जो टाइम लैग होगा, दैट टाइम लैग इज योर टाइम पीरियड ऑफ सिग्नल. T2 माइनस T1 मार्कर का टाइम वाला कॉलम हो गया वो मिली, तो माइनस 1 मिलीसेकंड दिखा रहा है क्योंकि T2 मार्कर पीछे रखा हूं मैं, T2 मार्कर को आगे रख दूं, सेम थिंग मेंटेन कर रहा हूं. ये पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव जाने वाला जीरो क्रॉसिंग, ये पॉजिटिव टू नेगेटिव जाने वाला जीरो क्रॉसिंग, तो दोनों को ऐसे जीरो क्रॉसिंग में प्लेस कर दो. नाउ T2 माइनस T1 कमिंग आउट इज ऑलमोस्ट 1 मिलीसेकंड. ओके, 994.318 माइक्रोसेकंड. दिस ऑलमोस्ट 1 मिलीसेकंड. 1 मिलीसेकंड टाइम पीरियड मींस 1 किलोहर्ट्ज़ फ्रीक्वेंसी. सुनो, सो are you in a position now to measure V peak voltage and frequency measurement using the oscilloscope observing the waveform? Can you do it? This is the very similar manner you used to do it in the lab, the physical lab, jahan pe tum actually tum CRO or concentrator ko handle kar rahe the, jo tumhara real physical lab tha, wahan pe jaise kar rahe the वोल्टेज मेजरमेंट, वी पिक जैसे मेजर करते थे, वी पिक टू पिक मेजर जैसे करते थे, द फ्रीक्वेंसी मेजरमेंट्स द वे यू यूज्ड टू डू, द सिमिलर अप्रोच इज बीइंग डन हियर आल्सो, बट हियर यू आर डूइंग थिंग्स वर्चुअल. अप्रोच इज सिमिलर बट द प्लेटफॉर्म हैज चेंज्ड. इज देयर एनी डाउट, कुछ क्वेश्चन अगर पूछना चाहो यू कैन आस्क.
So, थोड़े प्रैक्टिस करते हो देन वी विल आस्क इफ एनी डाउट.
ओके ओके हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट्स आर प्रेजेंट नाउ? 59 57 59 59. Okay, anyway, whatever attendance is getting taken care of.